Hi, today I'll explain about symbols in animate CC. Okay, this is very new to us. Yeah, symbols are actually the major asset, the big plus point for the Flash or animate CC. Okay, so actually this is the main strength for the Flash program. Okay. So symbols actually, what are symbols and how we can use these? Okay, so I'll explain. First let us let's start with symbols, symbols, symbols. Okay, symbols. So here the symbols are, suppose the one is graphic symbol. Graphic symbol. Symbol, two, movie clip symbol, graphics movie clip symbol, and three, button symbol. Button symbol. Okay, let us check what is actually symbols. Okay, generally what we do, any object if you want. Okay, suppose this is my object. Okay, this is my object, drawing whatever the shape or photograph also. The same the image or shape, if you want, what we do generally, we'll take Control C and Control V. Okay, so copy and paste. Okay, then again if you want a more, if you want to create more, then again Control C and Control V. Okay, so that means what, we are copying objects. In the same way, how many copies we want, we can copy and paste. That is the normal traditional method to duplicate that. Okay, so with this, what will happen? Suppose this is my shape, four shapes. Okay, so if I save this, it will take four image value. Okay, so suppose first I created this and again copy paste and again copy paste, so it is increment to four. So these four, if you save this, what will happen, this four can record in file size. So automatically your file size can be increase comparing with the one symbol. Okay, because it is multiplied. Okay, so automatically the size of the file also can be bigger. So the big file size are again is to Flash rules. The Flash plus point is the big file size. I mean the big animations, even the huge, the big lengthy animations must record in less file size. That is the main flash strength. But in this case here, if you copy and paste again, you are multiplying many times. Suppose there is a tree, okay, on tree there are a lot of hundreds of leaves are there or fruits are there. If you copy paste many times your leaves and your fruits, automatically your file size can be bigger, okay. But it is against to flash rules, must record the very less file size. So for that we use the symbols. Symbols are very very important, the main assets for the animate CC or flash, okay. In symbols we use three different symbols: graphic symbol, movie clip symbol, button symbol, okay. So graphic symbols are static symbols, okay. So in animation we convert into graphic symbol. It records into individual static frames, okay. So it shows you one object as individual static pictures or images, okay. So that I'll explain clearly. And in the second, movie clip symbol. In this movie clip symbol, actually your whole animation, suppose your animation is in 10 frames, 40 frames, or otherwise 1000 frames, or otherwise 10,000 frames, you can insert those 10,000 frames in one movie clip, and movie clip has the whole animation, okay. So one point of one simple movie clip frame, okay, if you double click enter into the animation movie clip symbol editing mode, you find your entire 10,000 frames animation will be there, okay. So clearly I'll explain this button symbol. Actually, so button symbols are for the user interaction purpose. We use the users can interact by clicking these buttons. So click, play, stop, start. For button user interface purpose, we can create the buttons. The buttons can be small, rounds, or otherwise a text, or otherwise a photograph, whatever it is you choose, okay. You can convert this into button symbols. These are actually the symbols. First, what we do, suppose here suppose this is mess, okay. So you can drag this to select, or otherwise click on this point, okay. And suppose right click, and here if you convert this into symbol, okay, so you can find this here, or otherwise select this, and suppose here make it new symbol also, okay. In new symbol you can give the name, whatever the name you want, right. So select this and right click, and suppose convert to symbol, okay. You are converting this into symbol, okay. Yeah, here this will ask you few questions. Suppose name, if you want to give name, and the type of symbol. Here we have movie clip symbol, button symbol, and graphic symbol. Just now I explained you these things, okay. So these are, in this we can choose anyone, okay. But suppose we start with the graphic symbol. Suppose here it is already in tick mark graphic symbol, and give the name here. Suppose box. I am giving the box, and here the registration marks. This is very very important. The registration mark. If you choose the areas, the left, round, bottom, top. Okay, so wherever you choose this registration mark. Registration mark means there is a dot like one spot will appear here. If you choose here, and if you choose this corner, so it goes this side. If you choose here, it goes here. Choose here, it goes here. Or otherwise here, here. We'll take here, here. Or otherwise here. Or otherwise center. Okay. So for time being, we can make it center. Now save OK. And suppose here in advanced options, with action script, your symbols can control. But see, we are not writing any scripts here because. Here in our course curriculum there are no action scripting or programming related stuff, so purely we are learning only animation and frame by frame animation and your training animation. Okay, so we use these animation techniques but not action scripts. Okay, so just you can minimize this, you don't want this. Yes, now say okay. Now see your the entire box converted into a symbol. When your box is converted into symbol, okay, if you find here the crosshair, this dot appearing here. Okay, I told you about this because you are choosing the center, or otherwise it can be appear. It may appear here, there, 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 anywhere. Okay, but anyway, we choose here. Right, so when you convert this into symbol, your merge drawing mode drawing converting into automatically the object drawing mode. Suppose around the box look like line, it is showing. Okay, so that means what, already this box converted into your graphic symbol, otherwise the symbol convert into symbol. So here what you do, this is your symbol, and even you can delete this symbol. Okay, but if you find this in library, still it is there. Okay, so suppose this is your box, you delete this, the old ones not required, this delete this. Okay, this is the graphic symbol. See the graphic symbol icon here, it is showing differently. Okay, and what you do, if you want to give the name, you can give the name. Otherwise suppose here I'm giving a red box, a red box, so it shows the red box. Now what you do, simply you can drag this onto stairs, or otherwise you can drag from this, see, so you can drag how many you want, see this, these are, so how many you drag, so 3, 4, 5. See this? Excellent. Yes, these are. Okay, these are actually what is not copies, copy or paste. We are not did copy paste. So these are called instance of the symbol. So how we understand instance means like. Shadows, your shadows, your ground shadows. When you measure, when you check your weight on weighing machine, So along with you, your shadow also can measure, but it cannot show you the separate weight for your shadow. Okay, that physically shadow can include with your the body weight. The same way here, the symbols are like your shadows. Like this means instance actually. How you say instance of the symbol. So how many instances you want, you can drag unlimited instances. When you save this file, what will happen? For one symbol or otherwise for one instance, how much the space it is using or taking to record this symbol, the same value, the same amount of the file size it takes for this 5 frames or even more also. So that means what, your instance can include in your symbols. Okay, so less file size issues. Okay, these are the graphic symbols, because these are statics. Okay, the static symbols, static images. Suppose here what I'm doing, I want to change this color because it is already converted into a symbol, that too in graphic symbol mode. Is it possible to change color now? Yes, you can. Now select that, and here in color effect choose the style. Okay, that is in properties, in properties color effect style, from none you can check the brightness, tint, advanced and alpha. Suppose here I'm giving the brightness. See, your brightness you can decrease and increase. Suppose if you give the brightness more, it is going to be a white. Okay, that is good. Then what I'll do, I want to check this again. Suppose here, suppose in brightness, otherwise in, yeah, in brightness we give this shade. Okay, right. And then here again choose advanced. In advanced category we have red, green, blue and alpha. So red 100, green 100, blue 100. You can add the more plus or zeros. Suppose here you can decrease or increase. Suppose it is going to be a orange, and now you can check this and give advanced, and here you can change this value. Okay, or otherwise you can decrease, so it's going to be a pink. The same way here you can use alpha also. Alpha means what, the transparenciness. Suppose this is the zero transparency, mean the visibility, there is no visibility of this. Now you can give the bit transparency, then you can increase, you can increase more. Okay, so if you want give the transparenciness, or otherwise from advanced, okay, then find the greens or whatever the colors if you want to give, can add that something like, yeah, suppose this is purple type, can add this. Okay, anyway, yeah, this is blue. Okay, so what we did, the main symbol is in actually red, but we converted all the instances colors. Okay, suppose if you double click on anyone, suppose here, see, you are getting into simulating mode. Okay, you are getting into simulating mode. That means at first, very first, you draw on stage one box, it's you and one box and stage, that is your the box. Here just try to give one change or otherwise another change to your the main object, automatically you are it is taking the same value or impact giving to the other instances. Okay, so this is now you can double click on that, you are coming into the normal instance mode. Suppose here you can double click again, you are going into that, and here you can try to give any changes. Any changes, okay? So it is applying all to the shapes. You can double click on the stage or otherwise here. See, there is an arrow mark here. Just click on that. You are coming out from the symbol editing mode. Okay? In symbol editing mode, you find your all shapes. Okay? Suppose you can double click into that. So what we are understanding here, even you gave coloring, different coloring to your instances, when you double click on that and enter into symbol editing mode, your main symbol you can find there and give any modifications to that, it won't affect, I mean it will affect the same correction to entire your all frames. So how we understand is, suppose there is a tree, on tree there are a lot of fruits or your leaves are there. Okay, so draw one leaf only and you can convert this into symbol editing mode, then give different colors, light green, medium green, yellow, so whatever the color. Okay, the same way, suppose you did 1000 frames animation, so your animation is about 1000 frames. There in 1000 frames you forgot to give one eye detail, you forgot to give one detail, or otherwise inside the black ball you forgot, unfortunately. After end of the animation, if you want to place your the black ball in 1000 frames or rather in 10,000 frames, okay, so it is impossible. So each frames, if you fill the same black color or whatever the shape you can create, again it will take time and it is really wasting of your time. So for that reason, what we do, you double click into simulating mode. Okay, suppose you double click into that and give the modification. Suppose here you are forgetting something, some eyeball type. See, I'm giving him in simulating mode this. Suppose this is eye. Okay, and here what will happen, what will happen, you are in 1000 frames, this will affect. Okay, this will affect in all the frames. So that is the main asset of the symbols. Are you understanding now? Okay, this is very, very important. So that is the reason the symbols are the main strength for the animation. So after creating 10,000 drawings also, it shows very less file size. because already we converted everything in symbols. Okay, so this is about simple symbols. Okay, so today I'll explain you the simple theory of symbols, and already I discussed about the first one is graphic symbol. Okay, I discussed this. Okay, so but practically we apply, okay, then only we'll understand. Of course this is also practically applied and I explain you, but more properly in the next class tomorrow I'll explain about graphic symbol, movie clip symbol and button symbol. Okay, and again tomorrow I'll explain more clearly. Okay, just you can try yourself, you can create whatever the shape you want and convert this into symbol. Okay, so follow this, it's very very important, don't neglect, you have to do yourself, then only you'll understand actually about subject symbols. Okay, if you have any doubt please ask me. Thank you.